हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू दिस सेशन। इन दिस सेशन वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट थायराइड हार्मोन एंड एंटी थायराइड ड्रग्स। थायराइड हार्मोन्स इज अ केमिकल सब्सटेंस मेड अप बाय थायराइड ग्लैंड व्हिच इज लोकेटेड इन फ्रंट ऑफ नेक। इट यूजेस आयोडीन टू मेक द थायराइड हार्मोन एंड सीक्रेट द थ्री हार्मोन्स नोन एज ट्रायोडोथायरोनिन, टेट्रायोडोथायरोनिन एंड कैल्सिटोनिन। द थायराइड ग्लैंड सीक्रेट्स टू टाइप ऑफ हार्मोन्स। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, फोलिकुलर cells of thyroid gland secretes iodine containing amino acids. These are the important for growth and development and metabolism. And these are triiodothyronin T3 and tetraiodothyronin, that is T4. Second one is that is calcitonin, which is important in the regulation of calcium level. It is secreted by parafollicular cells of the thyroids. The functions of thyroid hormones: it increases the metabolic rate. These hormones regulate proteins, fats, carbohydrate metabolism and stimulate vitamin metabolism. Thyroid hormone is important for the growth and development of all tissues, including bones and the brains. In adults, thyroid hormone helps to maintain brain function, food metabolism and body temperature. If we look at the thyroid hormones, it is secreted from this thyroid gland, which is located toward the pituitary glands. Hypothalamus. The thyroid takes iodine found in our diets, combine it with the amino acid tyrosine and converts it into the 3-3 containing 3 iodine atoms and T4 containing 4 iodine atoms. T4 is produced solely by the thyroid gland. So these are the structures of the basic amino acid from which these thyroid hormones are synthesized, that is tyrosine. The three forms, thyroxine, triiodothyronine and reverse T3, which is inactive form. The biosynthesis of thyroid hormone: the iodine is necessary for the synthesis of T3 and T4. It is derived from the food or iodine supplement. Iodine uptake is an active process. Once taken up by the thyroid glands, iodine undergoes a series of enzymatic reactions that converts into the active hormones. The six steps through which thyroid hormones are synthesized. First one is active iodine trapping. Second is oxidation of iodide and iodination of the tyrosyl. Residues on thyroglobulin. Three, coupling of the three iodotyrosine within the thyroglobulin to form the T4 and T3. Proteolysis of thyroglobulin. And fifth step is deiodination of the iodothyrosine within the thyroid cells. And intrathyroid deiodination, that is T4 and T3. So this is the overall process when iodine active transport in the form of iodide, it is trapped in the on the thyroglobulin, where it is to be converted to the MIT and DIT, and by the coupling of the MIT and DIT, it is to be converted by thyroid peroxidase, it is converted to the T4 and T3. There is a further process, lysosomal degradation occurs and T4 and T3 release, while the some MIT and DIT is recycled for the preparation of these thyroid hormones. And the T3 in the peripheral tissues is converted to the T4. So these are the structures of thyroid hormones. This is a monoiodotyrosine. So this is a tyrosine, that is aromatic amino acid. At the third position there is iodine, then diiodo, that is 3-5 position there is a 2-iodo, and whenever there is a combining of this MIT with the DIT, that will give the T3, while combining of the two molecules of DIT, that will give the T4. There is possibility of formation of reverse T3, but it is inactive form. So this is overall the mechanism of biosynthesis. Transport: thyroid hormones are avoid bound to the plasma proteins. Only 0.03% to 0.08% T4 and 0.2 to 0.5% of T3 are free form. Binding occurs to T3 plasma proteins: thyroxine binding globulin, thyroxine binding prealbumin and albumin. So this is how the T4 is utilized for synthesis of different proteins and for regulation of different functions of the body, that is growth, CNS, BMR, metabolism and cardiovascular. The thyroxine T4, the thyroid gland mainly produces the T4, is carried into the liver and kidney, where it is converted into active form T3. This helps in the regulation of the tissue growth and development. It is required for the formation of thyroxine. This is the chemical structure of thyroxine. Pharmacokinetics: thyroxine is absorbed from the GIT tract. Slower onset of action, longer duration of action. Liver is the main site of metabolism. And thyroxine is conjugated to glucuronic acid and sulfuric acid through the phenolic hydroxyl group and excreted in the bile. So this is the synthesis. Thyroxine is synthesized by iodination of the tyrosines and coupling of the iodotyrosines in the thyroglobulin. And thereafter it is released by proteolysis and secreted in the blood. Peripherally deiodinated to form triiodothyronine, which is exerts at the bloodstream of stimulatory effects on cell metabolism. There are some adverse effects. It will produce hyperthyroidism and hypothyroidism, cretinism and myxoedema. Cretinism is a condition characterized by the physical deformity and learning disabilities, while the myxoedema is another form of severely advanced hypothyroidism. This condition occurs when there is your body doesn't produce enough thyroid hormones. Therapeutic uses: mainly these thyroid hormones are useful in the cretinism, adult hypothyroidism, nodular thyroid diseases, myxoedema, coma, thyroid cancers. So let us see the antithyroid drugs. What are antithyroid drugs? So these are the agents which are the hormone antagonist acting upon the thyroid hormones and used for the treatment of the hyperthyroid conditions. There are classification of these antithyroid drugs. First of all, it inhibits the hormone synthesis known as antithyroid drug, propylthiouracil, carbamazole and methimazole. While there are some drugs which inhibit the iodine trapping known as ionic inhibitors, thiocyanates and perchlorate. Drugs that inhibit the hormone release: iodine, sodium, potassium iodides and organic iodide. While drugs that destroy the thyroid tissue, they are known as radioactive iodine, that is iodine-131 and iodine-125. So, very first of all, propylthiouracil, the chemical structure of propylthiouracil. The IUPAC now is, that is a 6-propyl-2-thiouracils. Physicochemical properties: it is an odorless white crystalline powder of starch-like appearance, iron touch. It is bitter. Saturated solution is a neutral or slightly acidic to the litmus and slightly soluble in water, practically insoluble in ether, chloroform, benzene and freely soluble in aqueous solutions of ammonia and alkali hydroxides. It is rapidly and readily absorbed from the GIT tract, readily crosses the placenta, widely distributed in the gut, accumulated in thyroid glands. It is metabolized in liver and excreted in urine. Mechanism of action: propylthiouracil binds to the thyroid peroxidase and inhibits the conversion of iodide to iodine. It inhibits the iodination of tyrosine residues. It inhibits the peripheral deiodination of T4 and T3. Thyroglobulin is degraded to produce T4 and T3. Therefore, propylthiouracil is effectively inhibit the production of the new thyroid hormones. This is how the synthesis of propylthiouracil occurs: 3-oxycaprolate when treated with the thyurea and cyclization, it will give the formation of propylthiouracil. So this is the condensation of the 6-oxocaprolate with the thyurea and elimination of 2 water molecules. Dose 200 to 300 mg per day in 3 divided doses. Usually maintenance dose is 100 to 150 mg. Adverse effect: it decreases the sense of taste and hear. It produces sore throat, headache, red skin rash, muscles or joint pain, edema, hepatitis, cholestatic jaundice. Another preparation is carbamazole. The chemical structure: so this is the ethyl 3-methyl 2-sulfandiene imidazole 1 carboxylate. The physicochemical properties: it is a creamy white crystalline powder, slightly soluble in water, so should stored in a well closed container. Again, the pharmacokinetic: it is more potent given single daily dose, completely absorbed and readily accumulated in the thyroid gland, less protein bound, has a longer duration of action, gets converted to the methimazole, which is an active, passes across the placenta is low. The mechanism of action decreases the uptake and concentration of inorganic iodine by thyroid. It also reduces the formation of tyrosine and thyroxine. Once converted to the active form of methimazole, it prevents the thyroid peroxidase enzyme from coupling and iodinating the tyrosine residues on thyroglobulin and hence reducing the production of the thyroid hormone, that is T3 and T4. There are also some adverse effects like white rashes, pruritus are common. Bone marrow suppression causes the neutropenia and agranulocytosis, sore throat or fever. There are sometimes stomach upset, mouth ulcers. So uses of this, it is useful in the hyperthyroidism and thyrotoxicosis. Doses 5 to 10 mg, 8 hourly. Maintenance doses 5 mg to 6 to 24 for 6 to 24 months. Brand name is Neomiracazole, Vidalta, Thyrocap. Thank you.